was called one of the founding fathers of the Memphis sound. What a legacy he left in Memphis music. He signed and produced Al Green. He produced Rod Stewart, Keith Richards of the Rolling Stones, John Mayer, and many more. As I said, one of the founding fathers of the Memphis sound, Willie Lawrence Mitchell. He passed away recently. We had him on our show several years ago. We're going to go back and present him once again. Ladies and gentlemen, they call him Pops, the great Willie Mitchell. On Memphis Sounds, my man, legendary producer, performer, songwriter, you name it, Willie Mitchell. Mr. Willie Mitchell, Manhattan Club, Bellevue Boulevard, Cotton Club, West Memphis, we could go on and on. But Willie, what I want to talk about, when you were producing, in your studios in Memphis, do y'all do head sessions, do you do rehearsals, or how does that, do they walk in with the songs, how does that all come about?
Well, when I do a session, I call a musician I want, and I write down the rhythm section, chords, if horns are coming in, it's all written down. And today, mostly who helped me with that is Lester Snell.
Lester Snell.
Lester Snell. Like, we go to the pen, and if I play something, Lester will write it down. And when guys come into play, then they have what I'm thinking.
Okay, now, for example, when Al Green comes in to record with you, does he have the songs in advance, or do they bring him in on the session, or they work them out, or how?
No. Al comes in. Me and Al go to the pen. We work the songs out, and sometime Al don't be there when we cut.
Yeah, you lay the track down, huh?
We lay the track down with Al, or if he's not there, we lay it down, because I know what Al's going to do. I know everything he does, see?
Yeah.
And I get together with musicians, like you got one out there, Bobby Manuel, for great guitarist.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and all I have to do is tell him what we're doing and what I want. And it's done.
It's done,
yeah.
Willie, you're a writer, too. You've written some great songs. Willie, when you write, what comes first, since you're a musician, also a great trumpet player, does the music come first or the words?
No, I usually put the music together. I put the music together, and then the words come.
Do most entertainers, Willie, like to record in the daytime or nighttime?
Most of them like to record at night, but, you know, some say, cut the lights out when I'm singing. It don't help. Yeah. It's all a mental thing.
Willie, some of the acts that you admire, not just maybe trumpet players, but acts in general, since you've been around for a long time.
Oh, God, it's been so many. I love Marvin Gaye and Aretha. I loved her. King Curtis. It's so many musicians. You can't, you know, it's so many of them.
Well, you being a trumpet player, Willie, what trumpet player really knocked you out?
Clifford Brown. He was the boss of everything.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Clifford Brown. Do you remember a guy named Bill Chase played trumpet?
Yeah, I got some. In fact, I got four CDs from him that Tommy Martin sent me.
Tommy Martin,
yeah,
I did for him.
Yeah. Bill, I know Bill real well.
Yeah, he was a good trumpet player, wasn't he?
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Willie, you worked with Keith Richards of the Rolling Stones. How was that?
Oh, that's good. Well, I mean, it's really good.
Yeah.
He's real professional, too.
They come in, they got their act together when they hit the studio and...
Oh, yeah, he comes in. He just won't see anybody. People hitting on the door, wanting the television, wanting radio pictures. He wouldn't do anything like that. But
he just came to work, huh?
Came to work. He's a good guy.
He really is. Keith Richards of the Rolling Stones. And this is, we mentioned it once before, but on another show, but this is the new Al Green CD that has taken off like a jet. It's already shipped gold, and the previous one went platinum, and I know that you're working on the third CD already.
No, Al's going to he's going to L.A. Sunday night to do Leonard's show and Ellen's show and what have you.
Okay.
But we're starting next week. I mean, not next week, week after next.
It's just a beautiful blend ship, Willie, of you and Al Green. It's just something hard to explain, isn't it?
Well, what you know, if I get an idea at 3 o'clock in the morning, I call Al. If he get an idea, he'll call me. He gonna get to say, "Well, what do you think about this?" And I say, "What do you think about this?" We got real good communication.
And that's foreseeable and that's understandable. Willie, just out of curiosity, you still live over in East Memphis. I know where you live.
Yeah, live
on. I see your car in the yard all the time when I drive by. The musical notes and writing on your front of your yard. Yeah. But Willie, when you go in your house at night, What music does Willie Mitchell listen to? What do you have on your CD player?
You'd be surprised. I don't listen to music.
You do it?
I don't ever listen to music. You know why?
Why?
I used to listen to music, and every time I'd hear something good, I'd write it. And I'd find out it's been written before when somebody's done it. I don't listen to records.
So you don't want to be influenced by something you've heard.
If I hear something good, I'm going to steal it.
That's our cut line, Willie Mitchell. You got the new CD out on Al Green. Thank you so much, Brother Willie Mitchell. Tell everybody I said hello to the family over there.
Thank you.
Willie Mitchell on Memphis Sounds with George Klein.